Can Pulsetto really help with stress, anxiety, and sleep? Or is it just another gimmicky snake oil gadget that'll wind up collecting dust in your closet? Well, after using Pulsetto twice daily for the past 30 days, I'll be showing you whether or not Pulsetto is legit, how to use Pulsetto safely, since I actually made a few mistakes at first that could have potentially done more harm than good, and who should or shouldn't spend their money on Pulsetto. But first, let's check this thing out. I just got an anti-anxiety shock collar. Sort of. This device is called Pulsetto, and it uses electricity to stimulate the vagus nerve, which is supposed to make us feel less anxious, more relaxed, and better able to sleep. Don't worry, I'm still gonna zap myself. First, we apply the included electrolube. Aw yeah, rub it in. Next, we position the device on our neck, then we choose a setting in the app. It's a weird, tickly feeling, but it doesn't actually hurt. What's that, Lassie? You want me to crank it up to maximum intensity? Roger that. Ooh, yeah, this one feels less good. Wow, a lot less good. Now, apparently, if I keep shocking myself with this thing, it's gonna help me feel less stressed, less anxious, and sleep better. Okay, cheekiness aside, that is kind of Pulsetto in a nutshell, but I still need to figure out whether or not Pulsetto actually works. So I went deep down the rabbit hole on the science behind these things so you don't have to. Don't worry, I'll make it quick. Basically, vagus nerve stimulation, or VNS, was approved by the FDA all the way back in 1997 as a way to treat issues like epilepsy and depression. But back then, devices needed to be surgically implanted to work, sort of like a pacemaker, but for the brain instead of the heart. Fast forward to today, now we have transcutaneous vagus nerve stimulation, or tVNS, which is the non-invasive option. Now, I'm not gonna bullshit you, tVNS is almost certainly not as effective as the surgical option, but there's still plenty of research behind it, and you don't have to go under the knife to reap the benefits. So I know which one I'd choose. And there are also huge online communities full of people using all kinds of devices for tVNS and reporting incredible results from them. I mean, honestly, it's almost cult-like how much these people swear that tVNS has changed their lives. And many of these people use and love Pulsetto. It's one of the top recommended options I see on there, but many others use super cheap, do-it-yourself, homemade tVNS devices, so if you're on a really tight budget, I can tell you more about those options later in the video. Speaking of budgets, if you do decide to give Pulsetto a try, I'll drop a discount link down below that'll keep updated with the best current deal possible, which right now I believe is maybe 10% off or something like that, and using this link will help support the channel, which I greatly appreciate. My personal opinion, not necessarily about Pulsetto, but about tVNS as a whole, is that if there's even the slightest chance it could make it so that you could get through life without needing harmful addictive medications for anxiety, stress, or sleep issues, it's worth at least giving tVNS a try. But just because tVNS is legit doesn't necessarily mean that Pulsetto is legit. So I use this thing like clockwork every day, twice per day, for 30 days. And honestly, the first few times I used it, I was like, damn it! I fell for the marketing hype. I think this might be a scam product. Because I felt anything but relaxed. The electrical sensation was so weird to me, I felt totally on edge, my neck muscles were spasming, my lip was twitching, I just definitely was not feeling like, I'm so relaxed and ready for a good night's sleep. But then I realized I was actually using it wrong, which is what I get for skipping the instruction manual. I was actually slathering way too much conductive gel all over my neck, which probably isn't the safest way to use Pulsetto. What I learned works a lot better for me is to apply the gel directly to the contact points on the device. For me, it's a lot more comfortable and a lot easier to clean up that way. It still took a few days for me to get used to the feeling of Pulsetto, even at the medium intensity of 5 out of 10, and I kind of compare this weirdness to switching over to an electric toothbrush for the first time. Super weird and ticklish at first, but once you're used to it, you don't even notice it anymore. Now let's talk results and fast forward 30 days later. Here's how Pulsetto worked for me. While Pulsetto claims to help with stress, anxiety, sleep, burnout, pain, and more, it can be really hard to measure those things honestly and objectively. I'm a pretty well-adjusted, healthy person with an already high HRV, low stress, no chronic pain, so with a lot of those metrics, I just couldn't really notice a significant change for myself. Although, many other people who have used Pulsetto claim that they have noticed those benefits from it. The one area I did notice Pulsetto had an effect was on my sleep. I've been trying forever to get my sleep cycle on an earlier, more consistent schedule, and the past month, I've actually been doing way better. One thing that could be helping with this is that for about 30 minutes to 1 hour before bed, I dim the lights, run the 10-minute sleep program on Pulsetto, and do some reading. By the end of my Pulsetto session, I'm usually pretty tired and ready for bed. Also, it may be a coincidence, but I've been waking up before my alarm clock goes off more often this past month. If you guys have seen my other videos, I am someone who really has a hard time with sleep discipline and consistency in my sleep schedule, so this is a big deal for me. I'm not hitting snooze 10 times and oversleeping, and this is also a little bit ironic because sleep is something I definitely did not expect to be affected by Pulsetto. Especially the first time I used it, I felt the little subtle electricity in my neck and I thought, yeah, this isn't gonna help me sleep better, but it's actually arguably where I've noticed the most significant benefits this past month. So while I do think Pulsetto is a legit product as a whole, there are still some major pros and cons to consider before you buy. For the pros, first, I've gotta say, this is definitely the easiest tVNS device I've ever used. I've tried plenty of other tVNS devices in the past, and I usually feel like the setup or the apps tend to make them a little bit clunky or less than convenient to use, and in turn, this makes me less likely to actually use them consistently. I don't feel that way about Pulsetto. I do think it's very easy to use, and the app has always been smooth for me. Second, I think Pulsetto could work for most people if they set the right expectations. This device is not a replacement for therapy, all right? There's no magic switch that makes anxiety completely disappear, but based on the research and my experience with it, I do believe it could help, and at bare minimum, I'd say it's worth a try before resorting to a lifetime of pills. And the third pro is kind of a segue into the cons, because it could be a pro or a con depending on how you look at it. I'm gonna put it as a pro, and that's the fact that the Pulsetto can go a little bit higher in intensity than most of the other devices I tried. Now, you can go super low on it if you're afraid or nervous about the feeling. It's really not that bad, and you get used to it very fast. I think it's a pro that it can go higher, because other ones I've tried in the past, sometimes they're either super low output on the voltage, or sometimes just vibrational, and that is where I get a little bit more skeptical of, like, is this actually even reaching my vagus nerve? Is this really doing something? So with the Pulsetto, I don't have those doubts quite as much. I do feel like if there's a vagus nerve in there, it's getting it. Now for the cons. First, you will need to purchase more electroconductive gel when it runs out, but fortunately you can find cheap versions of this for just a few bucks on Amazon, and you don't need to use very much of it for the device to work. I will say I have about half of it left in this container, and that's using it for 1 month, twice a day. So I would estimate one tube of this can last you about 2 months. Second, let's be real, it's not the cheapest device in the world. With that said, I will throw a discount link down below, which I'll keep updated with the best current deal to save you some money. And I genuinely appreciate anyone who uses it, as it helps a lot to support the channel. So, all things considered, who should and shouldn't buy Pulsetto? If you're dealing with any of the issues that tVNS devices like Pulsetto claim to help with, stress, anxiety, difficulty sleeping, etc., I think it could be worth giving tVNS a shot in some form, any form. And I think Pulsetto is a very convenient option for practicing tVNS at home. I especially recommend people try this before jumping into less conservative treatment options like potentially harmful and addictive prescription medications that you'll never get off of. But if you're expecting an overnight miracle cure for something like severe anxiety or extreme stress and burnout, and you think that getting this is going to totally replace any need for therapy or serious life changes, I think you've set your expectations way too high and would probably be disappointed with your purchase. Also, Pulsetto and tVNS in general are not safe for certain people, like people who have pacemakers or who are pregnant. Finally, if Pulsetto is just too expensive for you, even after using my discount link below, don't go into debt trying to buy one. A cheaper alternative that many people like to do to save money is to buy a TENS unit and modify it a bit to perform tVNS through the ear. Now, that's not something I've done personally because it looks like more trouble than it's worth, and I'd rather not risk doing it wrong and hurting myself, but if you're on a budget, there are other YouTube videos out there that can show you how to do this. If you're interested in more products that can help with stress and anxiety, check these videos out. Otherwise, consider leaving a like or subscribing to be notified about more awesome products in the future.